Ethics! Here we go! What is ethics? Before we get to that, some stuff about the class. About taking a philosophy class generally, about being involved in philosophy and the way it works, and so on. How many of you guys have taken a philosophy, an actual like PH class before, either here or in middle school? Few. It's not unusual that for most of the students that I teach never to have taken philosophy classes before, and that's fine. That's actually kind of fun for me to introduce people to something that I really like, but it sometimes requires a little bit of an introduction to what we're going to be doing. Philosophy courses, I think, are particularly interesting because they don't always have right and wrong answers, right? So there's a lot of room for discussion and question and questioning and kind of putting out thoughts and receiving other people's thoughts. But in order for that to work, there are a couple ground rules that are really important. One, you got to participate. You got to talk, you got to ask questions, you got to be involved in what's going on in class. If you just kind of sit, then you're not, you might be absorbing some stuff, but you're not really learning the way the class is intended to work. Two, part of participating is paying attention to what everybody else is saying. Right? Listening to other people, not interrupting, not sort of dominating the conversation, really letting other people be involved as much as you are. Right? General guideline, general rule of thumb is you shouldn't be talking any more than anybody else is. I mean, talk, but everybody should get a chance. Right? You want to be able to participate. And then the final thing is just, is about writing in a philosophy class. And what you may have experienced in previous classes, you've probably taken writing classes in the English, right, English department, or creative writing classes, that sort of thing. Writing in a philosophy class is different than writing in other kinds of classes. And that's really, really vital and really, really important in order to get across what you're trying to say, because we'll be talking about complicated things and things that that are not always easy to sort of express. So you really have to think about what you're trying to write. You really have to write carefully and clearly, and with a sense of where you're trying to go. What you don't want to do, and there, I've got some tips here. There's a little link called "Crucial Information on Writing a Paper." Some of this is a document I've used a lot over the years in a lot of different kinds of courses. So some of this won't always apply to you. But it's worth looking at just generally. This is on the class website, so you can go and look at it as much as you want, whenever you want. But some things to keep in mind is that you should make your paper as long as I have actually asked for you to make it, not shorter than that. That you should be clear and concise about what you're writing, and you should think about what you're writing before you start writing it. One of the big sort of no-nos or fatal flaws in writing philosophy papers, and I can totally see it when it happens when a student sits down and just starts writing. I'm just going to start going, and then I'll think about it as I go, and that almost never works. Very rarely will you get to the kind of paper that indicates how well you understand a concept that way. Understand concept much better than you think you do, but you sit down and you start writing, and the first half of the paper really doesn't even belong there. Just take it out and be just as good a paper. That's no good. When that happens, I will take it out. Right? So if I asked for a 750-word paper, which is about what I'm going to ask for every week, if the first 350 words don't really say anything, I'll pretend they're not there. I'll put a big X there and move on. Because any writing that doesn't actually say anything isn't worth the time. Right? You're talking about, you're trying to say something about what we're talking about, and that's important. Okay? So think about what you're going to say before you start writing. Right? Think about how you're going to say it. Think about possible arguments against what you want to say. Say you're writing about, why zebras are the best animal. Right? Zebras are the best animal ever. Right? Don't start with zebras are the best animal ever. I think zebras are the best. I really like them because they have stripes. Think about, before you start writing that, think about, what are my arguments for why zebras are the best animals ever? Like, do I have any points here? And what about the guy who comes along and says, well, tires have stripes, why aren't they really cool, right? You've got to have that thought out in advance, get that into your paper somehow. Right? You really have to sit down and think about what you're going to write before you start writing. It's kind of fun. The other really important thing about writing, do not, and you can get away with this in other classes, but it won't work here, do not write the way you speak, right? No one should ever write a paper, an academic paper, right? There are different kinds of papers, but no one should write an academic paper like it's a conversation. Hey, professor, how's it going? So this is why I think zebras are the best animal ever. I hope you agree with me. You know, if you don't, well, I never really liked you anyway. Right? That's not the way a paper should go. I mean, you want to think about some of the stuff that you're going to read in this class, right, which is definitely not going to be written that way. Think about how you want to express your ideas in a similar sort of fashion. Think about the change in, well, it's really a change in dialect. Right? We all have, you know, dialects like in the South, they speak a certain way. In Boston, they speak, right? They've got these different accents and dialects and different words they use and so on. Really, what you have to do is shift your dialect now from an informal sort of, you know, like, who cares how I say it as long as you understand what I'm saying, right? That's how we kind of go through our day, the way we communicate with people. You've got to shift that dialect to a academic writing dialect, which is different, okay? So you should, right, proofread, for errors, grammar, spelling, those sorts of things. I mean, I am going to be focusing on how you write because that's part of what this class is about. And I'm happy to help you if you feel like that's a weakness or you're worried about your writing or whatever. Talk to me, sit down with me, we can go over writing stuff. I'm happy to help you with that. But the other side of that coin is that I will be sort of looking at your writing and making comments and trying to help you get better at it. Okay? Any questions about writing? Writing's important because we're going to be doing a lot of it.
Drafts?
Absolutely, but the final has to be in when it's due. So you can certainly send me stuff in advance, and I'll look at it and send you back my thoughts. I'm happy to do that, actually. You're actually, in my whatever, 4 or 5 years that I've been here, you're the first person to ever ask me that. And I wish more people would send me that. What else? Yeah, if you're freaked out by writing, I mean, this is going to be maybe a rough class for you. I'm not trying to get rid of anybody. I hope nobody leaves. But this class is about writing. It's about communicating on paper. Paper. Probably won't be an actual paper. Probably all digital, but you know what I mean. All right. Most of this is pretty straightforward. If you want to read the rest of it at your leisure, I encourage you to. Padding. Padding is any time you add in words just to meet the word count. Right? I think zebras are very, 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 very straight. Right? That is obviously unacceptable. I've never actually seen anybody do that, even though I've always wanted to. But what I have seen are people who introduce, like, since the dawn of animals, there have always been many great ones. You can look at deer and elephants and coyote, right? But the zebra, right? That whole first two sentences is a waste. It's padding, right? We don't want those. I'm going to pretend that's not there, right? You don't need to convince me that it's a worthy paper topic. I assigned it. I already know that, right? So you don't have to explain to me why you're writing about it. Again, I know that already too, right? Just dive in. Write your paper. If you don't have enough thoughts about something to write 750 words, which isn't really that long, then you need to think about it some more. Right. Sit down, think a little bit more about how you feel, think a little bit more about what we've talked about in class. Right? I'm never going to just throw a topic at you. Right? Like, I'm not going to say right now, hey, open up your notebooks and write about Einstein. Right? That's not going to happen ever. It's going to be stuff we've talked about in class, questions that you have asked and I've answered and so on. So look at your notes. I hope you guys all, I noticed sort of left the notebooks out. That's very exciting. Look at notes. Look online. Research stuff. If you're not sure what a word means, look it up. You know, do the process. Be a student. It'll be cool. It'll be better that way. Finally, I have to talk about this. Copying and plagiarism are both unacceptable. If anybody's not 100% sure what plagiarism is, please ask me. Come and talk to me and make sure that you know, because plagiarism is totally unacceptable. I've had to fail students here before for plagiarism. I don't enjoy that at all. It's really, really unpleasant, but it is a thing that has to be done. The short version is, if it's somebody else's words and you're pretending they're yours, that's plagiarism. Right? And it's not very hard to spot, actually. So if you think you're going to get one by me, I encourage you not to try. It's not worth the game. Questions about that? Just don't do it. Yes. Last two things, and this is on the sheet, but they're valuable. Don't assume that I can read your mind. I can't read your mind. As much as I might like to, I cannot. So if you want me to know something, and by me, I mean the reader, you've got to say it. Okay? You've got to be present in the paper. Ooh, the iPad is shaking. So. And don't think that I don't assume that I agree with you. I mean, assume that I am a hostile witness or that I disagree, and you've got to prove your argument. Okay? If you don't have back foundation for your argument, if you don't have proof for your argument, again, it might as well not have happened. Okay? You can't just say, "Well, is everybody now?" How do you say your last name? How do you say your first name?
Raisha.
That was the thing I didn't care about. All right. Welcome. You missed all the exciting stuff. Everything from now on is boring. So to recap, is there going to be room there with the camera?
Oh,
it's going to fit in. Okay. I feel like I need to maybe find another spot. I was expecting a much bigger room, but like I said, this is the smallest room I've ever been in. So again, to recap, for those who just joined us, everything is on the class page, web page. Make sure you read the crucial information about writing paper. That's important, basic stuff. Okay, ethics. What is ethics? Oh, somebody remind me. I want to probably take a break at, let's say, 6:35. I'm sure I can trust somebody to. Tell me when it's 6:35. Okay. Everybody was able to find this? Everybody seen this before? This is basically the class syllabus. If you scroll down, you'll see all of the 8 weeks worth of stuff on there. It's a little bit under construction. I'm changing some things from previous classes. Previous versions of this class that I've taught, trying to make it better. One of the major things I'm changing is lecturing before the reading rather than the other way around. I found that students have a hard time reading about, say, egoism and then writing about it without me having talked about it first. So rather than reading and then we'll talk about it the week after, I will talk about it and then you'll read about it the following week. I found that's better for everybody. So that's going on with a lot of sort of construction on the website here, but this week is totally fine, right? So starting off. So I just don't want anybody to get too far ahead and start doing work in advance and then just get confused.
I try because you have a forum coming up.
Yep.
It doesn't have a date on this too.
Yep, because I haven't gotten to like everything. When you import everything over, it keeps the dates, and so everything says it's a year overdue and so on.
Oh, okay.
So it'll get fixed here as we move along. And honestly, I mean, it's great to be kind of ahead of the game, but I think things are complicated enough that if you try to go too far, you'll get a little lost, and I don't want that to happen. So it might end up being a waste of work. I would kind of just stay with it. Ethics. What are ethics? I saw some great responses in your posts there, in the forum post that I asked you guys to do where you introduced yourselves. And they all most of the responses kind of fit into these four or five different categories. Some of your thoughts about ethics include that ethics they guide humanity. By the way, these are all pulled from your answers, and I don't want you to feel either happy or sad if I chose yours. I just kind of randomly picked a like one that got repeated over and over and so on. So I'm not, I'm not either saying good things or bad things about these. So ethics guide humanity in decision making. Well, that's not a particularly helpful statement because lots of things guide our decision, our decision making. You know, like laws guide our decision making, and habits guide our decision making, and you know how you, the classic, you know, roll got out of the wrong side of the bed thing, right? You're just your mood can guide your decision making and so on. So we probably need something a little bit more specific than that in terms of definition of ethics than just something that guides our decision making. And then we got several. These are from different people's responses, but they're all kind of similar. Trying to live a morally grounded life. Ethics means having morals, and this is my favorite. I'm kind of picking on you guys a little bit. Ethics means essentially living ethically. Well, that's not really going to help us, right? If you right, the sort of one of the important things about definitions is you not use the word you're trying to define in the definition, right? What is blue? Right? Well, blue, you know, it's blue, right? That's not, that doesn't help us at all to define it that way. Ethics, yes, it does involve living ethically, but that doesn't help us if we're trying to figure out what ethics is. You'll note that the word morals shows up here. Morally grounded, having morals, using morals, ethics are morals and values. Yes, but ethics, the words ethics and morals, at this stage in the game are largely synonymous. They mean kind of the same thing. There was a time back in the day when people used those words differently. They come from different languages. Ethics comes from ancient Greek. Morals comes from Latin. Morals used to be more about sort of like cultural habits, and ethics was more about sort of like the study of those habits. But they've really kind of become the same thing. If you, I put the definitions of the two words up here, and you may have clicked on them, and they kind of both mean the same thing. So to say that ethics is morals, or ethics means having morals, is kind of like saying ethics means ethics. And that's, again, kind of a problem. So we need to go a little bit more than deeply into the question than that. We need to go a little farther. So, and then we got some farther answers, right? Doing the right thing, including following rules or the law, all right? Getting to work on time, following rules and policies and procedures. And then, right, this is a very common answer about religion, right? And the many ethics that come along with belonging to a particular religion. In fact, that's such a common answer, but that's basically what we're going to talk about today, all of today. We're going to talk about religion and ethics. But that, for reasons that we're going to discuss further today, doesn't really help us all the time. Including, right, rules and laws and religion and policies and procedures, they might not help us very much either, because, of course, we can all think of laws and policies and procedures and so on, that if we think about them long enough and hard enough, we'll come up with examples that we probably don't think are ethical. Right? We'll probably be able to come up with you know, policies that are technically the rule that we're all supposed to follow, but might not really jive with our ethics, right? When we start to think about what ethics are, that we might feel like, sure, that's technically what I'm supposed to do, but it doesn't feel right. And so part of what we want to talk about in this class is, why not? Why doesn't that feel right? What is it about that rule, procedure? I mean, doesn't feel right. And there's really, there's a pretty big spectrum. A great example, of course, is speeding. I suspect, guessing here, but if I had to do my mind reading thing, that most of you and I sped all the way here, right? Today. I was in my car and I went faster than the speed limit at least once. I know I did because I always do. Almost everybody does, right? We speed. Are we all bad people? Have we committed an ethically inappropriate activity? Have we violated the morals of our culture? Well, anybody think yes? Just out of curiosity. No, I don't think so, right? I don't think so. Part of the reason I know is because I'm perfectly comfortable telling you all that I sped on the way here, right? And no, I don't think any of you think less of me for that, right? I mean, maybe, who knows, right? I think you're more likely to dislike me for any number of other reasons than the fact that I sped, right? That's a law, right? I broke the law, but that probably has nothing to do with the rest of the stuff that we're gonna be talking about in this class, right? And then you can go even further. You can probably think of laws that, in fact, are wrong. I mean, there are hopefully fewer of them now than there used to be, but we can all think back historically on classic examples of laws, you know, with women not being able to vote and so on. I mean, worse than that, of course, that were technically legal, wrong. And so, like, laws, rules, and so on, that doesn't always necessarily mean ethical. And of course, as I said, we're going to talk a lot more about religion here, so I don't want to spend too much time talking about that. And then we got to a slightly different answer, kind of in the same range as the rules thing, where we talked about respecting beliefs. Respecting one's feelings and beliefs, factors such as religion, race, has its way in the way that a person thinks. Ethics just simply means beliefs to me. And we have to be really careful about the word beliefs. Next week, all right, I'm already thinking about next week. Next week, we're going to spend the whole time talking about why beliefs are not the way that we come up with ethics. Right? Because I guarantee you, if I polled you guys on some beliefs, we would come up with some wildly different answers about beliefs. Even things like, obviously some pretty big things, you know, like how many people in here believe that McDonald's is better than Burger King, right? I mean, I don't really care the answer about the answer to that question, but is that an ethical statement? Right? If you think that McDonald's is better than Burger King, is that saying something about your ethics? Well, no. But it's a belief, potentially, right? And then we can also get into things that we have to be careful about, like I was just talking about in the writing section, where I might say, I believe that zebras are the best animal in the world. But if you can't back it up, if you can't give me reasons for why zebras are the best animals in the world, then I don't care. I'm not interested. Right? And by professor, but also in terms of, like, if you're trying to convince me, if you're trying to make me understand why zebras are the best animals in the world, but you can't give me any good reasons, then I'm not going to be persuaded by that. And that's kind of the point. So we have to be careful about the word beliefs. And of course, right, this is not this class, unfortunately. There are a couple different, as I mentioned before, ethics is one branch of philosophy. There are several other branches of philosophy, and one of them is about knowledge. Right? A lot of people spend a lot of time talking about knowledge, and it's fascinating and really exciting. But we have to be careful about the fact, and I think we all know this if we stop and think about it, even though we might not always act this way. But we all know that belief is not the same thing as knowledge. Right? I believe that there are no aliens on this planet, right? But I don't know that. Right? There might be aliens in this room, but they're not the same thing. So when we talk about beliefs, right, ethics are about beliefs, then we start to get into dangerous areas, right? Because people don't always believe the same things, and how do I know my belief is right? And because knowledge and belief are not the same thing. So we get tricky, and this is part of what we're trying to do in this class, is to talk about ethics not as a system of beliefs, right? Because people will believe anything. People will believe, there are almost 50% of people in this country still believe that Donald Trump won the popular vote, right? Like, won the popular vote. 50%, that's 150 million people. A lot of people who believe that thing. It's just false. You just look it up online, it's false. People believe it. I bring that example up only because I saw it today on TV. As something that, crazy thing that lots of people believe. What was my point? My point was that what we want to do in this class is come up with ethics and treat it more like a science. Treat it more like an approach that you would use in physics or chemistry or biology, where we're talking about, I don't want to just base this on beliefs, I want to have knowledge about ethics. I want to approach it in a way that we can, you know, sit around and have a discussion that's based on, you know, a bedrock of things we know, and we can advance from there. So I just want us to be careful about the words belief, and certainly feelings. Wow, feelings is the worst, because we're human beings, and we're the worst about feelings, right? We get angry at bad times, and we get sad at stupid times, and who knows what makes us happy, right? And feelings are just wrong. So we've got to be careful about feelings, because I say lots of things at certain times that I don't really mean or think or feel, because I'm angry or whatever, right? The Romans used to call anger a brief madness. Like, you literally went insane for a little while. Because that's, right, we've all done things when we're angry that we wouldn't have done otherwise. So we've got to be careful, certainly about feelings, but even about beliefs, because unless you can support those beliefs, then they're just, you know, they don't help us very much. Finally, we got some of these things, right? How we feel about what is right and wrong. Right and wrong. Essentially what it boils down to. How do we know what is right? I'm just fiddling with things. How do we know what's right and what's wrong? What is right and what's wrong? And it's a really fascinating conversation to have, right? What's right and wrong? I asked about sort of like, what do you expect to get out of this class in that intro post? And a lot of you were sort of like, oh, I don't know what I'm going to get out of this class. Or, you know, I just want to pass. But I think it's interesting to it's interesting to know why people take an ethics course. Does anybody want to share why you're taking this course?
It's a requirement.
It's a requirement, yeah, right? That's a big one. And that might be everybody's. I don't even know. I mean, honestly, right, that might be every single one of y'all's reason for taking this course. Anybody take this course just because it sounded cool? Either for lying and making me feel better, the one thing I don't want that I feel like some people take the class because they think they're going to learn what is right and wrong. Like, I'm going to go take that ethics course and I'm going to come out of there and I'll be able to tell everybody in my family what they're doing wrong. It's going to be awesome. Right? I totally wish because if I could do that, I'd fix my family first. Because my family's crazy. Probably not. Probably not going to happen. It's not another question. What? Hopefully, at the end of the day, when we walk out of this course, what you've done, and even what I will have done as well, is improved my ability to think about these things for the future. Not that I will have come up with answers, necessarily, but that I will have gotten a little bit better, and every time I teach this class, I get a little bit better, at thinking about issues and problems that face me and people I care about and people generally, and helping them to figure out what's the best way to approach those problems and issues and so on that they face. So it's really, this is a course about getting better at thinking. Better at thinking in terms of getting rid of some of the beliefs feelings that affect us, right, that aren't necessarily grounded in anything, right? Kind of pushing those out of the way because they can certainly affect the way that we think. Right? We've got to kind of divorce ourselves from those things that mess with us, and getting better at defending our beliefs and our arguments, right? Trying to get somewhat closer to knowledge, right, through discussion, through reading what some other really smart people have said, not necessarily taking it as gospel. Right? Just because some smart guy that I asked you to read said a thing doesn't mean it's true. But reading his argument can be really valuable. His or her argument can be really valuable. And then being able to come up with your own arguments against them and so on. Like, these are all the sorts of skills and steps we take in order to get better at these things. And so that's ultimately kind of the point, I think. And who knows? I mean, you may you may, through the course of this discussion and talking to your fellow classmates and talking to me, you may be able to come up with some answers to some things that have been bothering you and you're not sure the right way to approach it. And we can talk about those things if you want to, and then that would certainly make me happy if we got to do some of that. Questions? So how do we talk and study about ethics? The last question I have down here, like I said, we're going to do a lot of reading, we're going to do a lot of writing, and we're going to hopefully do a lot of talking in this class, discussions of things. A lot of the things that we do in this class involve sort of like hypothetical situations, often pushing things to their sort of, well, if you believe this thing, then what about this very extreme version of that same thing? Can you support that as well? And if you can't, then what's the difference between those two points, right? Sort of thought, I can't think of a word all of a sudden. Yeah, that's not the word I was looking for, but I like it. So thought-provoking discussions, just sort of like trying to work our way through possible ramifications, looking for things that make a statement or belief absurd or inconsistent. Right? Those are the kinds of videos. So that's a lot of what we'll do in class. And we'll do a lot of, hopefully, I'll bring up a thing and you guys will say, well, I think, and then hopefully someone else will say, but, right? And that's how we have these conversations, ideally in a calm and respectful way. I haven't had anybody throw anything at anybody else in a class before, but I'm always afraid of the first time. Everybody here seems pretty mellow, so I'm hoping that one will come up. Ah! There's a cool comic strip here, but it doesn't fit on the screen, so look at that at your leisure. Ethics and religion, so this is where we're starting. And this is I'm intentionally starting at a slightly provocative spot. I'm trying to be a little bit, annoying is not the right word, but I'm trying to push some buttons here at the beginning of this course. Because it is my experience with Albertus Magnus students that many of you are quite religious people. And that's okay. However, what we have to do is take a good hard look at ethics and religion and where they kind of meet, where they don't meet, whether they're just the same thing, how connected one thing is to the other. In the course of your little posts that I was reading, the introductory posts, I was actually surprised that religion, the word religion, didn't show up more often than that. Because in my past experience, there's been a lot of, ethics is what God tells me to do. And that's one way to look at ethics. But it's not the only one. How many folks are, you don't have to answer this question if you don't want to. If you're comfortable talking about your personal religious thoughts, then you're welcome to share them. When we talk about religion, how many of you guys sort of immediately fall back to, it's sort of what it says in the Bible, / your book of choice that is your religion. How often, Myrna, yeah, that's kind of what you fall back to. Yes? Anybody else feel like sharing that? Yeah? Yeah, Patrick, you're also in the Bible. It's common. It's very common. Lots of people are happy to go to that because it's all right there. Right? We've got lists and lists of thou shalt nots. Right? That's easy. It's a user's manual of like what to do and what not to do, and that's what we all want, is a guide for how to live our lives. Can we imagine why someone might say no to the question, are ethics the same thing as religion? I mean, are they the same thing? How many, anybody think they are? The ethics just is religion.
I think so.
Jessica?
I think they go hand in hand.
How
come? Ethics
Sure, sure. It's hard to argue with an all-powerful guy telling you to do stuff, right? Like, clean your room, right? God showed up and told me to jump off a building. Like, all right, that's a hard thing to argue with. Tishon, what are you saying?
I think some individuals, depending on the upbringing, may use religion as their basis on what they deem ethical and not ethical. I don't think ethics is religion, or neither religion is the other.
Yeah, I mean, sure, that's a bad question, right? Obviously, they're not exactly the same thing. Or we wouldn't have two worlds, right? You just have one word and it would be the thing. But in terms of trying to determine right and wrong, like when we're trying to decide, you know, should I fill in the blank, whatever the blank is, whatever the action is, are we comfortable simply turning to religion and answering the question via Bible or maybe talking to a pastor or someone like that? Or do we think that there's more to that answer?
I'm still kind of thinking about it, but I feel like ethics is kind of like, I know most people believe like religion was kind of like first, because God was first.
Uh-huh.
But I feel like ethics is kind of like a base. Because they really do kind of go really closely hand in hand.
When you mean that you think ethics was first, like a base for...
Not that it was so much as first. It's really hard because I almost feel like they're like... I almost want to say they are very close to the same thing because I'll say I guess I'm religious. But...
You don't have to apologize for that.
I feel like they kind of mean the same thing, just depending who's using it. Like, I do use my religion to assist in my decisions.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel like even if I wasn't religious, I would use ethics. Like, I feel like they're just...
Okay. So you see there's a division, is what you're trying to say. You see that there's
I feel like there's only a division because people have made it like a division. Like, because people can be so religious, it turns other people off. We now use ethics instead of saying, I go based off my religion. I'm kind of still sort of an idea.
So for you, and I'm just paraphrasing here, mm-hmm. or I'm trying to repeat back so that you can clarify. For you, it's really all based in religion, but we've started to use different vocabulary so that people don't get turned off by the word religion.
I don't feel like, I don't know if I can say I'm saying it's based off religion, because I'm religious though.
Okay.
But for someone who's not religious at all, who has no belief in that, they probably wouldn't use that term religion. They would just stick with ethics.
But really, secretly, it's all based in that. They just don't.
I think it's hardwired in our DNA. It's hard-coded in our DNA.
Religion or ethics?
Ethics.
Okay.
It's because even if a child does something wrong, not knowing, once the child is raised, don't do that, and the child, you grow up and you do something, even if you go ahead and you did it consciously, there's a conscience that bothers you. You're going to steal. You're going to feel something that don't do it, but you do it anyways. So
but
I think it's hard-coded in our DNA, even if we don't,
if you have
no belief in religion whatsoever, mm-hmm. there's something that's hard-coded in our DNA mm-hmm. that kind of wrestle against wrong and right, even if we continue to do wrong.
But if it's something that has to be, that you have to be trained to figure out, like as you said, like a little child doesn't really know
wrong
what's
or right,
wrong.
You're taught wrong.
So it's
or
not
right.
actually a biological thing, right? It's part of
but
society.
But I think as life goes on and you grow up, and even if you're not raised, if we're not, say, it's not tied to religion,
mm-hmm.
because I know people who are not religious that will not do certain things that people who are religious do. Right. Actually, they're not doing it.
So certainly,
because it's right.
There are good people,
you know,
who are not religious.
Yeah.
And there are bad people who are.
Talk about taxes. And yes. When you're doing your taxes, you know, you have to make a decision ethically what you're doing and what you're not doing.
Oh, Christine, you're hopping all over the place. So and right there's something there, because we've got to be careful, because we already talked about the fact that laws and ethics maybe not the same thing.
Yeah.
So someone who doesn't do their taxes might not be
saying decisions you make in doing your taxes, you can put certain things
down. You mean
about
lying on your taxes?
Exactly.
But maybe that person feels like, oh, it's a corrupt system, and they're stealing from me, and here I am, Robin Hooding, and so this is actually a good thing.
Right.
You know, like, right?
See, that's why it's hard to, that's because they almost are, I feel like ethics, I don't know, it's hard to say which one came necessarily first, but I think religion does set a tone, because it's so, like, with the whole Bible being there, it's like, thou shalt not do this, this, that. I feel like a lot of this stuff that we deal with ethically is kind of under that umbrella.
Stems
from that.
From there.
Marissa had her hand up for a long time. Then Chelsea. And then
they hit a few points that I had.
Yeah.
But in the same breath, I feel like ethics and religion is kind of personal to each person. Because something that somebody that's more religious than I am might do, I wouldn't agree with, according to my ethics. And then some people run to the Bible and, like,
I'm gonna let you keep going, but I just want to respond to that real quick with the statement that, God, I hope not, right? I really hope you're wrong about that. Because if it's actually just personal, then this whole 8 weeks thing is going to be a waste of time, right? Because if your answer is just like, my ethics are mine, and you can't tell me what they should be.
Use religion, like when it fits them, not overall.
Well, that sounds like a problem with religion.
Right, but
right?
They are like the same, but then, I don't know.
Okay, so it's complicated.
Yeah.
Particularly when people claim to be religious, but then maybe, I know, I'm not going to get a second anyway. If I keep fixing it, it'll make me crazy. Right, so some people call themselves religious but aren't, right? Or they don't really follow the tenets of the religion, even though they claim
to
be.
They use it to their certain, not everybody, but they use it when it fits best with them, because there's certain things in the Bible that it says to do and not to do, and some people don't.
So that's really interesting, right? Does everybody see why that's really interesting? Why is that really interesting? Anybody? Because right there we have someone who is acting according to their religion, and yet we still see him as acting poorly, badly, right? So here's someone who's both religious and bad. That means that religion and bad and good are two separate things, right? Or at least they can be, right? And so we're talking about them as separate ideals, and therefore maybe they're not as sort of grounded one, grounded in the other, as we tend to think they are. Maybe. I think that's a really interesting way that you put that. I'm not sure. Now, I think a lot of people will say, well, that guy who says he's religious and is acting badly just isn't, right? He's not following the religion, and so he can say anything he wants about himself. He could say he's from Mars, but it's not, right? And so maybe there's an argument for, still an argument for religion being tied to ethics.
For instance.
Yep. Look, hold that thought for now. Is that a direct response? You know what I'd love to do? This is, if anybody here do like computer programming or coding or anything? A little bit? What I really want is like an iPad app that has like keeps track of people who are having a conversation, but allows, and so you know, like I have a point I want to make, and it would add you to the bottom of the list, unless you're gonna respond directly to somebody, and then it would allow you to hop up, right? And you'd all have a little buzzer and you'd be able to like, if anybody wants to make $1 million, I recommend that. I would buy it. I wouldn't pay $1 million for it, but I would buy it. Chelsea, I think you were up. But unless, Myrna, you want to directly respond to what Marissa
was
saying.
This is like Marissa says. And
thank
the
you.
Bible says, thou shalt not kill.
Yes.
But there's war. So you have to. Like, during war.
Oh, but do you?
Well, if you're in war and you're in battle, you know.
But it's like some religious people wouldn't join the army.
Right.
True.
Yeah. right? Yeah, there's a, right, the, is, we have to be really careful about you have to. Because
the line of, fire.
Maybe. I mean, what was that Hacksaw Ridge movie? Mm-hmm. The guy was, he was right there, he was right in the middle of everything, and he never picked up a gun. Right? And that's supposedly, I don't know if it's based on true story, it says it is. It's complicated, right? Because we do have, and we should, right? I shouldn't assume, but I do, based on my past experience, that most of you guys are Christian, if you're religious at all. And most of the people in this country are familiar, at least, with the Ten Commandments. Although, honestly, I'd be surprised if more than one of you could name all 10. Can anybody name all 10?
I
bet you as a group, but even maybe not, right? The thou shalt nots that we always think of, like the killing and the stealing and the coveting, neighbors well. It's harder than you might be thinking, because most of them don't actually, I mean, when you think of the Ten Commandments tell you what to do, really only four of them tell you what to do, in terms of the rest of them are about God. Yeah, there's some about God. I am God. Like six of them are about I am God, and one of them is about, no, five of them are I am God. One's about your parents, and then the other four are about not being a bad person. My point is this, that there's way more in the Bible than the Ten Commandments, right? We get into those thou shalt nots, but there's a whole, right, there's a whole Leviticus and Deuteronomy that spent a lot of time talking about things you should and shouldn't do. Why did I bring that up? I don't remember. Just that it's complicated. That's my point, right? It's complicated when we start talking about thou shalt not kill, right? That is maybe the most quoted and least understood statement in the history of the world, because every single person in this room can think of a reason when you'd be okay with it, right? You may be the most peaceful person you've ever met, and yet you can think of a reason why you may not do it, but you'd certainly think about it, possibly, right? And that's just kind of the nature of being a person and life being complicated and hard. More complicated than a single sentence in a book, no matter how cool the book is. Patrick, did you have a comment you wanted to make earlier?
No,
you were just pointing at your call. That's right. All right, you're in charge of that. You're doing a great job. I'm going to go for another 4 minutes. Cool. All right. Chelsea, did you make the point you wanted to make earlier? I'm trying to make sure I got everybody.
No.
No, go for it. You totally don't. Totally don't.
Back off of what Crystal said, because I agree with her statement. I feel like one's religion or religious views kind of shapes their ethics or what they consider to be ethical. Because in my opinion, if you choose to believe in God, whoever your God is, you're religious. And if you choose to believe that there is no God or higher power, that's a religious view because you choose not to believe.
I've heard that before, like atheism is a religion because it's, faithful, you have to believe, and I don't buy that.
I'm not saying it's a religion, but it's a religious view. You're choosing not to believe.
It is a view about religion, yes. Which is slightly different. Slightly different. I think the beginning of what you started to say is really important, which is that religion can affect and sort of can play an influence on people's ethical beliefs. That's totally true, 100% true. Religion often has a significant impact on people's ethical beliefs. However, other things can also have a powerful impact on ethical beliefs. Where you live, right? There are things in this country that we consider right and wrong that people in other countries feel totally differently about. And then even within this country, your ethnic, economic class, your gender, right, can have a big impact on things like that. My mom and I disagree kind of weirdly about parent-child relationships, right? In the sense, I think that it's really important that parents are comfortable being parents, right? You can't be happy, you can't make your kid happy until you're happy, sort of thing. Whereas my mom believes that no child-parent relationship is the most important thing ever, right? Like, which is a weird thing, because she said that in front of her current husband, and I think that's, I don't know how he took that. but it's just, right, so, like, and so, and I don't know if that's a generational thing, or if that's a woman-man thing, or if that's a she lives in Wisconsin, I live in Connecticut thing, or what, right? They're all of those things can have an impact on your sort of view of right and wrong and so on. So to say that religion has an impact on your ethics is absolutely true. The question is, how much of an impact should it have on ethics? Should our ethics be based on our religion? Should right and wrong be determined by you know, the version of the book that we ascribe to? Right? Because that's kind of the question. And so, well, I'm going to give you guys a break. I'm going to come back. We're going to talk about that some more. We're going to get into some very specific reasons about why maybe you should or shouldn't. And then we'll talk a little bit about some how religion is impacting some stuff today. So one of the things I want to do each class is spend a little bit of time talking about just an issue that's actually happening in the world, because I know that's what some people really want to talk about all the time, and so that's fine. So take 10 minutes. 10 minutes, good. And then be back here ready to go. Ready to go. Pause.